What's it feel like out here at Drake Stadium, the crowd out there, and the final race?
Well, no, last year in Sacramento, everyone left for the distance races, so it was nice to have the stands pretty full, and it was definitely loud enough to, you know, make you push extra a little bit.
As you prepare for this NCAA championship, you feel like you were in your best performance shape as it was?
I didn't get a chance to go run like a fast 5K out west or anything, but my workouts and everything were going great, so I was kind of off the radar just because I hadn't run any really super fast times, but my fitness was always there the whole season.
And weather conditions tonight, perfect
awesome.
For your running.
Yeah, awesome.
Well, again, congratulations.
Thank you.
On your
Thanks.
Yeah, you went, congratulations, first of all. I mean, that was unbelievable. I think from 4,600 to 4,800, you went like 26-something.
Sweet. Oh, wow.
I mean, were you checking the screen at all, seeing how far ahead you were?
I was pumped, but Coach O'Sullivan was like, look, do not go until you know you have the thing won. And from 800 meters out, I was thinking, I was kind of tripping over myself to stay behind Vaughn. And then with 400 to go, I was just feeling on the home stretch, and I was like, I can't wait any longer. And then just had to, I mean, a guy like Brett Vaughn, I figure you have to just totally go all out, or else he'll just follow you and not kick you.
And you talked about it, about being kind of overlooked.
Yeah.
You know, kind of sticking to the East Coast and not going out to Stanford, maybe.
Yeah. That might have been a good idea. I think a lot of guys are very fixated on going out to Mount Sac or Stanford and busting a good time. And actually, I would have this year if 10 relays wasn't scheduled how it was. So maybe that was a blessing in disguise.
I was actually one of the guys that doubted you coming into this race.
Oh, yeah?
I think you were 13th or 14th on the national list coming in.
Worse than that.
And, you know, obviously you've shown that doesn't even matter.
Yeah.
And as, you know, he just alluded to, staying on the East Coast, not going on the West Coast so much, that's got to feel pretty good for you to come out here and win a national championship.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. And I was totally scared shitless when I saw he ran 13-18 at Stanford. So, I mean, I'm not going to lie, it was kind of a disadvantage, but kind of an advantage as well.
So what are you looking forward to, you know, this day forward?
Well, I guess this time now, we'll qualify me for the 5K if I want to do it at the trials. So I got to pick either the 5K or the 1500, but then I'm going to go to Europe and do three races in July. So
Do you know specifically where in Europe
these
two races are?
Yeah, I'm going to run a 3K in Italy on the 13th, the Houston 5K in Belgium on the 20th, and then 1500 in London.
So you're going to still obviously stick around the area, train through the summer?
Yeah, yep.
Okay, good luck.
So did you and Marcus kind of have a plan mapped out for the race?
Marcus is so casual about everything. He didn't even talk to me before the race. He's just one of those people that's like, give you very broad advice. Sit and kick, for example, would be something he would say. Nothing more specific than that. But I think with his training and just his style, by this time in my career, he would hope that I would know what to do at this point, and I wouldn't need to just look to him for advice. So, yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.